After years of focusing exclusively on carbohydrate counting, nutritional recommendations for people with type 1 diabetes might be getting a tweak thanks to research coming out of Joslin Diabetes Center on the effect of fat on insulin dosing.
So this research grew out of clinical observations in patients with type 1 diabetes using continuous glucose monitoring. And what we noticed was that several hours after meals, people's glucoses were going up. And on reviewing food records, what became evident was that this was usually following people having had a higher fat meal. But no one has actually yet applied that understanding and those insights in terms of what the implications might be for people with type 1 diabetes who are on insulin.
Dr. Howard Wolper and his team at Joslin conducted the study at Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center. 7 adults with type 1 diabetes stayed in the clinical research center for 2 days eating carefully controlled meals. Breakfasts and lunches had identical macronutrient content. Dinners matched in carb and protein, but one was low fat and the other high fat. Insulin was monitored and dosed on a closed loop system.
So we were able to show that when people ate a higher fat meal, that their blood sugars were higher for longer and required more insulin.
What was also interesting, and it has implications, is that in addition to needing more insulin, the actual insulin delivery pattern needed to be adjusted. So the effect of the fat tends to kick in several hours after the meal.
Physical activity is also a component of how that fat affects your blood glucose. We did have one study participant who exercised vigorously, and the effect of fat was very different from all the other study participants.
Follow-up studies are developing improved dosing algorithms for high-fat meals and changes in general nutrition recommendations for people with type 1 diabetes.
So what this really kind of points to is really a shift in the whole focus around intensive diabetes management when it comes to nutrition and bolusing, taking insulin at mealtime.
Even though anecdotally people knew that fat was affecting their blood sugars, we wanted to bring it to the forefront so that the siloed carbohydrate counting way of dosing could be re-looked at, re-examined.
This is was a new application of the closed loop technology, which is used in the artificial pancreas program to answer an issue that's of therapeutic importance for people with type 1 diabetes. Most of the studies in terms of closed loop have been focused primarily on developing the system as a tool for diabetes management, but none of them have actually been applying this technology in terms of the impact on incremental improvements in diabetes management, which is where we've been using it.